watching your pretty smile so warm. And I am already halfway out the door. Then you'll go and kiss me, say you're tipsy, baby.
CFC Thoughts YouTube channel. Today we're going to be reacting to Swansea City versus Crawley Town, which took place this afternoon when Swansea beat them 3-2. And we're going to also be doing a reaction to Mansfield as well, which was last week, and obviously what went down there. So obviously it's going to be a good video. I get it to be calling this pre-season roundup. So let's get into the video then. First off is the Mansfield game. We won 2-1. We won 2-1 to Mansfield, and an ex-scummer scored for them. Obviously, not the best way to concede a goal in the first pre-season match, but okay. And obviously, then we responded with a Barry Mackay. I think it was a well worked goal by the Swans. I believe he's a it was a quite well worked goal. But then and then Wayne Routledge scored then in the dying moments. I think it was the 89th minute or the 88th, I'm not sure. But it was a good game, good comeback as well. And obviously we saw some appearances of some under 23s. Players such as John Garrick, Ben Cabango, I think Cameron Evans started as well, and so a few others. And obviously we had quite a good comeback as well. So obviously it was quite a good result for the Swans to kick off their pre-season. Obviously 100% record at the Steve Cooper now. I don't think I'll be saying that for much longer. I believe we can win these next remaining pre-season games, but it's going to be tricky facing Atlanta because they were like Champions League last season. So obviously it'll be quite a tough test to face the likes of Atlanta, who are very, very good team. So that was my reaction to Mansfield game. Let me know how you felt about the Mansfield game, and moving on to Crawley Town.
Next up, my reaction to Crawley Town.
What can I say about this game, really? It was quite a productive game. I'd say first half we were excellent, actually, because we didn't concede at all. Nordfeldt actually can catch now, so fair dues to Martin Margaretson, I think his name is, who has been coaching Nordfeldt, and Mulder and Bender now. But we opened the scoring with Nathan Dyer cutting inside into the box and scoring, just dipping it over the keeper. And then we had Matt Grimes' set piece, or free kick as you may call it, converted into a header, which is headed in by George Biles, who's recently signed a contract. So that'll be quite pleasing for him, obviously getting the contract as well. And then in the second half, then we scored with McBurney, who has got his first goal in the 2019-20 campaign. He's gonna score goals, and he bleeds goals literally. I think we saw I can't remember his name, but who's the second goal was scored by former Bolton Wanderers winger Philippe Maurice, who is now at Crawley and playing in League Two, obviously. So I can't remember what the goal was like, but it was a quite silly goal to let in. Obviously Bender lacking in experience,
You're gonna get that from a goalkeeper, aren't you? But we would have preferred him to Nordfelt last season, obviously when he couldn't catch, and when he wasn't been training right, and when he couldn't catch. So obviously we're gonna be looking forward to this season. Hopefully Bender can develop into a good goalkeeper. He'll get his time, but in the meantime we'll just leave it down to Nordfelt and Mulder, who are obviously experienced goalkeepers. In my opinion, I'd go for Mulder at the minute, because he wasn't in the squad for Crawley, obviously, as he broke his finger. So we're going to have to see what happens with him. Hopefully he's fit for the start of the season. But if not, no worries. But, you know, I'd like to see him back in goal. It'll be obviously a good start for him as well. So obviously we're gonna have to see what happens, aren't we? But the Crawley Town game was a very entertaining game. Fair to Sir Jacks as well, who went to the Mansfield game and the Crawley game as well. We brought decent support up to Crawley today. We didn't bring numbers, but we brought quite a few up, to be fair. And it must have been a laugh. So obviously, I wish I could have gone, but you know, I don't know. I'd rather go on Championship away day. So obviously, we're gonna have to see what happens next season. We move on to I believe it's Yeovil now, and then Northampton, and Exeter, and then we got Atlanta, and then the start of the season. So obviously we're looking forward to that, and obviously we are eager to see how Steve Cooper does in the Championship and his ambition to get us into the Premier League. So obviously it'll be quite interesting to see what he does, but in the meantime we're just gonna have to hope this team develops in pre-season, and Steve Cooper's gonna have to look at his strengths, some weaknesses in the squad. You know, Jake Bidwell did okay today. That wasn't the best, but I believe he got taken off at half time for Declan John. He put in a decent performance, John, since he came on. But you know, it'll be quite interesting to see what Steve Cooper does. But thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe with notifications on. We just reached 300 subscribers, and I cannot believe the amount of support you've been showing me. It's been a pleasure doing this for you guys. Hopefully I can continue on into the future and hopefully get more subscribers as well. And obviously a thank you to the Swansea Vloggers again. I just really appreciate them. And I'd hopefully be working with them most of the time next season. And obviously I'm hoping so as well, such as like Reese Connemore, who I've never met before, to be fair. Curtis, who I've only met once in QPR. Pure Iber Gamers, who I met in the Holland Derby game, obviously. Talk the Swans Vlogs, probably gonna meet them next season. And obviously we're just gonna have to see what happens. And Total Swans TV as well, who can forget about him, really, to be honest. He done well on his previous account, but it got copyrighted and got taken down. But really interesting to see how I can. I'm looking forward to working with these guys, because fair dues to them, they're all doing great, each and one of them. And I only wish the best for their channel. So thank you again for watching this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and turn notifications on. This has been Marley, SCFC Vlogs, and I'll talk to you another time. Come on, you Swans.